four-time MVP LeBron James has been named the honorary starter of the iconic 24 Hours of Le Mans, which is celebrating its 100th year. As the official starter, the King will be tasked to wave the French flag to start the prestigious race on Saturday. Some of the prominent personalities that have been given the role of honorary starter include tennis legend Rafael Nadal and Hollywood star Brad Pitt. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com. In sports, a crucial Game 4 of the NBA Finals set to go down in Miami tomorrow. Now, a win for the Heat will level the best-of-seven series, while a victory by the Denver Nuggets will have them on the cusp of their first-ever NBA championship. Steve Angeles tells us more.
Back to the practice courts for Philem head coach Eric Spoelstra and the Miami Heat on Thursday morning. After suffering a 109-94 Game 3 defeat to the Denver Nuggets in the NBA Finals on Wednesday night, Spoelstra says despite the 2-1 deficit, the Heat's competitive spirit remains strong.
Yeah, like a lot of these games, there are certain things that you like, and you think that you can continue to do those things. I liked our aggressive attacking mentality. And then there's things that, you know, we feel like we have to do better. And this is great competition. You know, those two guys can manipulate your defense in different ways. And one of the biggest strengths we have is our competitive spirit, nature, you know, just to overcome whatever. Even if players play well or a team plays well, that we figure out how to get the win at the end. We were not able to do that. You do have to credit them.
One big question mark for the Miami Heat is their 2022 Sixth Man of the Year, Tyler Herro, who has been injured for most of the playoff run. Herro has been participating in practices throughout the finals.
Yeah, this is just part of the process. You know, you have to go through stages. First part of it was just shooting, then movement, then contact versus coaches, and then the next level of contact in practice. He has not been cleared for a game, and he's still not cleared yet.
Now with a home court advantage, the Nuggets are focusing on the series one game at a time and are looking to continue correcting some of their mistakes from Game 3.
We're addressing all the areas where we have to be better. Too many turnovers, too many offensive rebounds. It was nothing celebrating the great nights that Nicole and Jamal had. More importantly, it's about how can we find a way to come out tomorrow night and get another one here in Miami, heading home to Denver for Game 5.
We go into every game trying to win. We try to win every game, home or away. Try to win every game. We don't plan on losing the game. So whether home or away, we're trying to win, and just kind of react off that.
Game 4 will tip off on Friday night in Miami and returns to Denver on Monday for Game 5. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News.
ABS-CBN News' OB Ranger Project bags the Broadcast Innovation Trophy at the Asia-Pacific Broadcasting Awards in Singapore. The AB or OB Ranger Project stemmed from the challenges faced by ABS-CBN News amid the non-renewal of its franchise. It's an innovation to operate multi-camera live coverage without the usual equipment that relied on the franchise. Also recognized in the awards is ABS-CBN Global, which nabbed the Excellence Award for OTT platform for its live streaming app, I Want TFC. ABS-CBN's Big Dipper also earned the Innovation Award for audio description, providing an inclusive viewing experience for hearing-impaired audiences. The Transformers film franchise has switched gears in its latest installment by adding more diversity to its lead roles. Yong Chavez talks to the stars of Transformers Rise of the Beasts.
In Transformers Rise of the Beast, Anthony Ramos plays Noah, a former soldier struggling to find employment as a civilian who's desperate to support the medical needs of his younger brother. In the middle of this, he meets Optimus Prime and other Transformers Autobots. Ramos, who starred in A Star is Born with Lady Gaga and who first gained notice on stage through Broadway hits In the Heights and Hamilton, says that like his character, he knew firsthand what it means to go up against the glass ceiling. Not many Latino talents have had a chance to lead a huge Hollywood franchise like Transformers, so he's mindful of its significance.
What does it mean to you to be the lead of a franchise as you just is, and how did you relate to the struggles of Noah?
It means a lot. You know, it means a lot that we get to, you know, me and Dom coming from similar neighborhoods in Brooklyn, New York, you know, we get to do this movie together, and we get to infuse our flavor into a franchise like this that is usually in a specific kind of neighborhood with a specific kind of family. In a, you know, my mom was single parent. I'm a little brother, right? So in our movie, it's the opposite. I'm the big brother. I relate to that relationship a lot. The home team handshake they have, that's a thing that my dad used to say to me.
The movie, which is set in the 90s and features the era's iconic music, also stars Dominic Fishback, who plays a brilliant archaeology researcher who found the important object that the Autobots and their enemies were looking for.
The struggles of your character, you know, the way that she was not being recognized for her brilliance, initially.
It resonates for sure. I think you work so hard, you give everything you have, and like they obviously they talk about how acting is like mostly rejection. You know what I mean? So you go hard for things, or you feel like, okay, your team might be like, okay, this is the one that's gonna blah blah blah, that's gonna get you to be able to do X, Y, and Z, and then you get it and you do it and it's like still crickets. And it's okay. It's like as long as they see the work, it, you know, that's what matters.
Fishback bonded with Ramos on set and even sang his songs to him.
Your impromptu rap with Anthony Mackie was like iconic. Did you try one with
first of all, In the Heights was the first musical I ever saw. I love that musical, and then I got to see Anthony do it at the 10-year anniversary of the Heights. And then I watched the movie, obviously, and so we'd be on set and I'd be like I'll just throw a line up like stuff or something like that.
You start singing different
the
parts.
The only room with the view is the room with you in it.
Transformers Rise of the Beast also features the voice talents of Michelle Yeoh, Pete Davidson, Christo Fernandez, and Peter Cullen as the iconic voice of Optimus Prime. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.
Pope Francis's recovery from his abdominal surgery is going well as expected. The Vatican says the 86-year-old is on a liquid diet and is well enough to receive communion and make a phone call. The Pope underwent a 3-hour operation in Rome to repair a hernia. His doctor said Francis will remain in the hospital for about 5 to 7 days. The Pope has 2 upcoming trips in August, and his doctor said no changes are necessary to this travel schedule. Former U.S. President Donald Trump indicted by a grand jury for alleged mishandling of classified government documents and obstruction of justice. Now, Trump wrote on his Truth Social platform, the Biden administration informed him of the indictment over what he called was the boxes hoax. He even claimed President Joe Biden has over 1,800 boxes of documents himself in several locations. Trump has been summoned to appear at a courthouse in Miami on Tuesday. Now, sources said Trump is facing 7 criminal cases. The criminal case brought by the U.S. Justice Department stems from roughly 13,000 documents seized from Trump's Florida home nearly a year ago. Biden asserted he did not interfere in the investigation.
Because you notice, I have never once, not one single time, suggested to the Justice Department what they should do or not do, or else to bring in a charge or not bring in a charge. I'm honest.
Trump's indictment draws mixed reactions from both sides of the political spectrum. Republican House Speaker Kevin McCarthy says this is a dark day for the U.S. as he accused President Biden of indicting the leading candidate opposing him in the upcoming elections. Another Republican, Florida Senator Marco Rubio, said there is no limit to what people can do to protect their power and destroy those who threaten it. Meanwhile, Democrat House lawmaker Adam Schiff said Trump's indictment is an affirmation of the rule of law, adding the former president should be treated like any other lawbreaker. A U.S. constitutional professor explains just how significant this indictment is.
It's the first time in American history that a former president has been indicted on federal charges, and it comes shortly on the heels of the first time in American history that a former president had been indicted on state charges. The walls around former President Trump are closing in from a legal perspective. These are very serious charges, and they're also the kind of charges that if the federal prosecutors and the Department of Justice are bringing them, are likely to be particularly easy to prove.
Heavy smoke from Canadian wildfires continue to choke U.S. cities, halting flights and disrupting outdoor events. In Washington, the air quality alert was raised to code maroon, the highest category, signaling hazardous conditions. This prompted the White House to postpone an outdoor pride event. A Major League Baseball game in the afternoon was also paused due to the noxious heavy smoke. Meanwhile, in New York, Governor Kathy Hochul reminds residents not to be complacent as air quality levels continue to reach unprecedented numbers.
The message is this is not over. You know, we might get a little respite, but I don't want people to let down their guard and to become complacent about this, because we have to be prepared for the winds to shift. This is the unknown. We're tracking the large plume that is originating from primarily Nova Scotia, eastern, you know, and also Quebec, but also, you know, knowing that this is going to continue to have a negative impact on our health.
Debris suspected to be part of a Chinese rocket recovered in waters near the Philippine province of Bataan. The Philippine Coast Guard says the wreckage resembles the top section of China's Tianzhou rocket. The debris is now in the safekeeping of the Coast Guard in Limay, Bataan. China launched its Long March 7 rocket on May 10th in Hainan province. The Philippine Space Agency had warned rocket debris might fall into the waters near Zambales. Southeast Asian nations set for their first ever joint military drills in the South China Sea. The exercise, which will take place in the North Natuna Sea in September, comes amid Beijing's increasing aggression in the disputed waters. ASEAN bloc observer Timor-Leste will also be participating. Indonesia says the drills will focus on maritime security and rescue and will not involve combat operations. The ASEAN nations have held naval drills with the U.S. before, but never as a bloc on its own. Beijing asserts ownership of most of the South China Sea despite competing claims from other Southeast Asian nations, including the Philippines.